on WWL-TV. The Spirit of Louisiana. This is Louisiana's news leader, Channel 4's Eyewitness Morning News.
It's become a common back-to-school sight, seeing the students carrying very heavy backpacks. Some of them look almost as big and heavy as the child, him or herself. And while it looks like they are getting a great education, what they're really getting is back pain and poor posture. And joining us this morning to talk about the health hazards caused by carrying too much weight or wearing that backpack incorrectly, very happy to have Bryce Teal, an occupational therapist at Touro Infirmary. Bryce, thanks very much for coming in and sharing this, because we've all seen the kids, you know, leaning forward under the weight of it or carrying it on one shoulder and that sort of thing. And I guess as an occupational therapist, you must cringe when you see that.
I do. I mean, it's important to remember what you want to do with your backpack is really just pack it right, wear it light, is a little slogan we like to say. Mm-hmm. It's important to remember weight. You never want a backpack to weigh more than 15% of the child's body weight.
And it would be nice if the schools had two sets of books, you know, a set of books to keep at school and a set for the kids to have at home so they wouldn't have to carry so many books.
That really is the best case scenario. Unfortunately, that's not always practical.
Okay, so then you have a certain number of books that you have to carry. How do you recommend that people pack their book bags?
Well, what you want to do is distribute the weight. And the best way to distribute the weight is you want to put the heavier books closest to the back and the lighter books and notebooks further away from the back. And, of course, your school supplies, pens and pencils in the outside pockets. It's important to have a backpack that has many compartments, so that way you have, you know, a large compartment for your bigger books and even your laptop, of course, right up against your back.
So you're looking for something in which it would have a separate compartment that you could put that in. And as you said, you want to load the heaviest items closest to the student's back.
Exactly.
And then arrange books and materials so they weren't going to slide around. And consider, now, do you recommend having a book bag on wheels? Do you think that's a good idea.
Unfortunately, it's not always the coolest thing. Mm-hmm. It kind of loses popularity as kids gain in age, so that's why I really try and teach kids, you know, the right way to wear it as well. So
and
once you have it packed.
You have to check with your school to make sure that you can, you know, have the book pack on wheels. Some
yes,
schools
that's another issue.
That. And then you want to distribute the weight evenly on both straps. And what do you say to the kids? Say, oh, it's not cool for me to wear it on both shoulders, so I just wear it on one shoulder.
Well, it's probably not cool to be walking like this when they're older either. It'll throw off their posture.
And so this is something that will follow the young person through life.
Yes.
So these things, okay. And then another thing, you want to make sure that you select a pack that with well-padded shoulder straps.
You have well-padded shoulder straps.
And so you want to make sure you want to look for that. And what else do you want to look for in a backpack?
Well, you have the well-padded shoulder straps. And it's good for them to have a little bit of a curve, so they'll be more ergonomical to the child's shoulders and chest.
And I look at here, it's a little padding here as well that would be against the child's.
Yeah, that just protects from sharp corners and books and things that might poke into the child's back. The other important thing you want to remember is when you wear it, how to adjust the straps properly.
Okay.
You want to have the back of the backpack should hit just below the child's shoulder blades. And
just
the top,
below, okay. And the top
should be right in the small of the child's back. So right about like that. So you don't want it below their waist. You want to keep it above their waist and then below the shoulder blades.
Okay. So those straps are there for a reason. Now, do you think
these are great. If you can find straps with extra straps, better, because you've got more weight distribution. A lot of them have the waist straps as well. Those are great to connect. It just distributes the weight more and makes it more comfortable for the child to wear.
And as you said, when you're talking to the child about doing all of this, the reason is because if they injure their back now, it's going to have an effect as they get older. And, you know, this posture that may seem cool now, being leaning to one side as you're carrying your back, it's not going to be so cool when you get older.
No, and it causes a lot of back pains. It can really cause problems later in life.
Let's put some of those full screens back up are we finished? We are finished. We've covered it all. Bryce Teal, you've done a good job, and thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.